One of the main recipes of keeping the desirability of a product intact is to keep on updating it, especially when you know the competition is growing tougher at a brisk pace. TVS has always been working with the same formula. In November last year, the company truly wowed us by introducing three riding modes in a 200cc bike, the Apache RTR 204V. 3 months after that, the company added 2 BHP of power in its smaller sibling, the Apache RTR 164V. A motorcycle that was already one of the best in performance. The company also managed to shave off 2 kilos from its overall curb weight. Now the question is, have these changes made a substantial difference in the bike? Has a good product gotten even better? We try to answer these questions by riding the motorcycle extensively. Do watch the video till the end, and if you like it, do not forget to subscribe to our channel. Let's start off with the crux of the matter, the engine. Powering the Apache is a 159.7cc single-cylinder oil-cooled engine with 4 valves per head. It churns out 17.4 bhp of power at 9,250 rpm and 14.73 Nm of peak torque at 7,250 rpm. Besides power, even the torque output has gone up by a small margin. The most notable aspect about the RTR 160's engine is that it really likes to rev to its red line. Unlike many other bikes in its class like the Hero Xtreme 160R and the Bajaj Pulsar S160, which feel a bit strangled after a certain point. The Apache feels calm and relaxed at lower revs, but once you get past 4000 RPM, it shows a bit of eagerness to go faster. And keep revving it beyond 5000 RPM, and there's an exhilarating buildup of momentum which keeps on getting stronger until about 9000 RPM. Accompanying the potent engine is a clutch that doesn't require too much of an effort to operate. Although it is not as light as a slipper clutch, I must say it's pretty close. Even the gearbox is sleek and seamless to shift, making it stress-free to ride in city. And although it's not really meant for munching long miles, you can cruise between 90 to 100 kmph of speeds for a long time without a sense of major strain on its engine. Another thing about this engine that I truly admire is how soft and muffled it sounds at lower revs. But as you give it the beans, it starts telling loudly that it's an engine derived from the RTR 165 race prototype machine. Listen to it for yourself. Now, as you go on rolling the throttle in any gear, the vibrations don't climb as much as the exhaust note and speed. The Apache is almost vibe-free. You can just feel slight tingling around your thighs beyond 6000 RPM. Coming to the handling part, thanks to advancements in engineering over the last few years, most of the bikes in this segment, like the Suzuki Gixxer, Hero Xtreme 160R and the Bajaj Pulsar NS160, they all handle beautifully. But I think the Apache RTR 164V takes things a notch higher. Try hooning the Apache around in the city and it doesn't seem to break a sweat. The direction changes are quick and composed, with a light steering and a chassis that responds with precision. It doesn't even mind being pushed hard around tight and long sweeping corners. Well, the Apache 160 was already this good a handler, so 2 kilos weight reduction hasn't really made a noticeable difference in terms of handling. Instilling more confidence in the rider are the Remora tires, which deliver excellent grip and feel. So do the brakes. The front and rear disc both return ample bite with the right amount of progression. The rear is a little bit too soft, but the front compensates for that by being up to the mark. We would have loved to have a little more feel from the front brake lever. The suspension setup has been tuned to deliver sporty handling, which results in the ride being slightly on the stiffer side. Well, it's definitely not jarring to the extent of being an annoyance, but when you go over sharp bumps, potholes or road joints, the rear feels a bit too bumpy. However, it doesn't get in the way of the pleasant experience you have on the bike. The recent update didn't bring along any cosmetic changes in the motorcycle, and we aren't complaining at all. It already looks pretty sporty and modern, with a distinctive looking headlamp, a muscular fuel tank and a sharp tail. And complementing its looks are the fit and finish levels that are just about right. The Apache RTR 160 is also a technologically advanced motorcycle with a full LED headlamp and tail lamp and an instrument cluster that shows much more than just the basic data. Apart from things like speed, RPM, time and fuel level, you can also view race-oriented stuff such as lap times, 0-60 timer, top speed recorder and more. The display is also legible on the go and in different light conditions. Now, this instrument cluster could do with a gear position indicator, but maybe that's asking for too much in this segment. Well, something that's really fancy for a bike of this class is the glide-through technology. What it does is that it prevents the bike from stalling. It keeps the bike moving ahead at slower speed, in lower gears without any need of throttle inputs from the rider. It works in first three gears at different speeds. By now, it's confirmed that the Apache 160 is quite a likeable motorcycle, but it's not flawless. And the biggest problem is with the side stand. I had pointed this out in the video review of the Apache 200 as well. So the main problem is, the length of this side stand is so short that when you park it, the bike leans a bit too much. This might not be a big problem when you are parking it on a nice flat surface, but if the ground is slightly uneven, it feels that the bike is going to just fall off. Another problem is the position of the foot pegs. These are placed quite a bit high and at the rear. Don't get me wrong, it never gets uncomfortable. But for someone who's upgrading from a 110 or 125cc commuter bike, most of which have neutral ergonomics, this might feel a bit odd. But it's just a matter of getting hang of it. And the seat deserves a special mention here as it scores really high in terms of space and cushioning. And even the handlebar is pretty easy to reach, so no problems there. Now, to answer the main question of this review, has the Apache RTR 160 gotten even better? Well, although marginally, but it has. The performance difference is quite evident as it now revs more freely and feels quicker as well. Other qualities that were already good and have been retained include its handling, comfort and technology. Not to forget its ex-showroom prices that start at ₹1,07,000. So the only bike that's cheaper than the Apache is the Yamaha FZ, while the rest of the rivals are marginally more expensive. To conclude it all, choosing the Apache RTR 160 4V would definitely be a wise decision.